because there's a special catchweight challenge coming up. Grasshopper takes on Fit Finlay this afternoon, along with Princess Paula, after this break.
Blonde-haired boy from Lewisham, with an arm lock now on Bobby Anthony. Bob Anthony of Chelmsford. No score, 5 rounds to go. Continually going for the Japanese stranglehold, and he's given a great chance for Barnes to do an airplane spin. Get him. Rather like Steele and Quinn, or even Maxine and Elijah in the first bout this afternoon, has got to think of staying away from the strength hold that he can. Inside leg kick, actually. Nicely turned, but he gets caught in the head. Appreciated by the crowd. Good escape. Caught on the way. Anthony going for the reverse double leg Nelson. Can he hold it by leaning back? All the way on the bridge. All the way on the bridge. He might have him. He has. Very nice move. It just took Bob Anthony 2 minutes, 13 seconds to get the first fall over Bobby Barnes. And I, for one, would have bet quite a lot of money against that happening. Very neat.
And 2 minutes, 13 seconds of the second round. The first fall of the contest goes to Bob Anthony.
Giving away a stone and a half, and with his left arm troubling him, Bob Anthony still gets the first pinfall in round two. But there are four to go. Very seldom you see Bobby Barnes trail against a lighter man. He's going to be a little angry about that, I think. He might go in with some strength holds now. Yes. Object to weaken his opponent from now on, and not allow him to come up with a move like that again. Triangle hold. Trying to make a backbreaker out of it, too. With the crowd up here in South Yorkshire, really appreciate the good escape move. There's not too many crowds that do. They go for attacks all the time, but they don't really appreciate the nice escapes in contest. Not all of them, anyway. Double A Nelson answer. If they make it a 2-0 win, that would be a turnout. Position anyway, even if he can't complete the counter, he's out of trouble for the moment.
Wait.
And this time back, and again, a little anger. It's a bit of a knee there. He gets straight on the ropes, and he goes straight on the ropes, all illegal. Doesn't like it too much when the crowd cheer either, and an escape by his opponent. Oh yes, it's a nice way. Truck it beautifully on the way over. Now we could be in trouble from this one, but if he doesn't submit, there's no chance of Bobby Barnes getting a pinfall from this position. So Mamad Anthony can take it. He has. He can work again for another escape. Well, he's got the figure four leg lock on now. His own leg is right between there, though. He's locked with the figure four. Curious bars coming through from the other side. I don't know if you can make that out. It's a melee of legs, but Anthony could have the... now that he's sitting up, I'm not sure, but he could have had the advantage from that. Half a minute left. And again he's out. Again he's out, but without leaving go of his man, so he's fought entitled to go for him. And he's on the deck because he hadn't got off the deck. A little drop kick there by Anthony. Belly down, reverse double knee, but no, he never hold it. Just 5 seconds to go. Never hold it. Never hold it. Good effort though by Anthony to complete a counter move after that escape. Very nice indeed. Bob Anthony, originally from Chelmsford, now in Camberley, actually, of course, this man is a vegetarian. He's what is known as a lacto-vegetarian. But he can drink milk and dairy products, eggs, things like that, but he can't go for any meat. He runs, of course, the famous Pantiles Restaurant and Roadhouse at Bagshot in Surrey. 3 rounds to go. Bob Anthony still leading. Bobby Barnes, surprisingly, started round four by 1 fall to nil. Anthony returned to the ring after quite a long layoff with his wrestling business. He's been on television. This is the third time, or third or fourth, and he really has shown a tremendous improvement since he first came back. Managing very well against the heavier Barnes. Show up too well on his first bout, a little better on his second, but now he's really coming back to it. Maybe some Dragon fans will remember before he left the ring for quite a spell. And Hess going over the top, taking his man a double leg Nelson chance again. He's after a 2-0 win, isn't he? He really would be surprised if he could pull that off over a man like Brian. Liable to happen. Of course, Barnes going into the forearms now. He's taking a lot from this fellow. forced up into her. A restless bridge. Rather than his head being touching the canvas, it's the barn's feet holding the head there. But again, by the end, he gets out of it, climbs up the top part of the body and goes for a cross press. He's thrown out of the ring for his pains, but it was a good effort. Wondering what he was going to do then. Wondered a little too long. Stood there. Backhand. Opposite arm. Reverse chop to the stomach. Barnes doesn't know what the day is at the moment. He really has to. Oh! Forearm now. Too early, too early, too early. And a couple of minutes and a four. And Anthony's doing extremely well. Leading, remember, by that 140 gain in the second. Quite determined to increase that score. Get it all. But the forearm, it was a forearm, legitimate. Showing his escape capabilities here. He really has done well as that, didn't he? Anthony needn't worry. The bell will help him out in a minute. The referee doesn't. So Bobby Barnes, he probably came into the ring here this afternoon thinking, well, this man's a stone and a half later. He hasn't done too much recently. It was quite a long time when he left the ring for a spell. I think probably it'll be pretty easy. But he's not finding it so at all. He's trailing by 1-4-0, remember. Bobby Barnes, anxious to get going now. As the bells clutch, round five. Yes, it's Bobby Barnes finally. The last two rounds deciding to go hard on the strength moves. But Anthony can swing a few forearms too. Just as much as Barnes' face or wherever it caught him, because Anthony's in trouble with that right knee. He really caught it too well for him, actually, and they're both counted out. No, it's Bobby Anthony couldn't get up. That knee really got him into trouble there at the low. Barnes is still wavering a little unsteady on his feet. Bob Anthony's knee is afraid to put him out of his spot.
Anthony failing to beat the count. The winner, Bobby Barnes. And ladies and gentlemen, now about one for the loser, please. Hey, right.